Hello everyone, welcome to The Geoecologist. I'm Dr. Krishnanand and you have been watching my videos on geomorphology, physical geography and other parts of geography. So in today's session, we are going to learn about the fluvial or the geographical cycle of erosion given by W.M. Davis. But before we go ahead, please like and subscribe to our channel and don't forget to share the videos with others as well. So now, let's learn about the cycle of erosion which was given by William Morris Davis. So it's W.M. Davis, which is one of the core components of geomorphology, especially when we learn about the theory of landform development and also slope development. So let's learn about this particular theory, that is cycle of erosion. Now, one more thing that is to remember here is that this has several names here. So it is also known as peneplanation, the theory of peneplanation, that is making of peneplains. Then second name is the slope decline theory. So peneplanation theory or cycle of erosion theory is also known by the name of slope decline theory. Then further, it is also known as geographical cycle of erosion, or many times people also refer to it as fluvial cycle, that is the fluvial processes involved. So fluvial cycle of erosion by William Morris Davis. So, W.M. Davis, what we see here is, he was an American geologist and geomorphologist who presented his concept of cycle of erosion. And remember, the title of his work was Geographical Cycle of Erosion in the year 1889. So, this is important. And this concept was given in his work, Complete Cycle of River Life. So, remember, the name of his article was Complete Cycle of River Life, in which this concept was given, that is geographical cycle of erosion. So this is one of the most popular theory of landform development that we study in geomorphology, and it provided a genetic classification. When we say genetic, it basically means about genesis, and genesis is origin. So it is talking about how this particular landform originated. What are the important classifications? What is the system of description of landforms on Earth's surface? So this is why it is very important. So what he said was this sequential change of landforms. It means that landforms also go through evolution, right? So right from the beginning of Earth till today, it has been evolving with time. So this evolving is sequential in nature. So this is the word that you have to pick when we say Davis theory. It is about sequential change in the landforms or landscape. That is important. Now let's elaborate furthermore. So Davis introduced the idea of recognizable landscape. Now remember this idea of recognizable landscape. That particular landscape which you can go see for yourself, recognize, observe and understand that landscape and their stages of evolution. Now here is important that this is about space concept here and this is about time concept here. So this is what is pure geography, the space-time concept in Davis concept. So stages of evolution in his cyclic model. Now this is important to understand that his cyclic model was described as by this particular statement that we know, that is landscape is the function of structure, process and stage. So what do you understand here when we say landscape is the function of structure, process or stage? It basically means there is a functional relationship. So you must have heard this X is the function of Y. This is what we understand if we take it mathematically or statistically, right? So X is the function of Y. It means for every X value, there is a Y value corresponding, right? So it means for every landscape, remember, landscape is function of this structure, process and stage. So number one, number two, number three. So for every landscape, for every recognizable landscape that we see in particular stage of evolution, these three processes, these three important factors are important, right? So structure, process and stage. So structure is what? Which includes the nature, that is largely hardness, permeability, the physical component. Then the attitude, that is folds, faults, joints, all these things that we have studied in the diastrophism. So nature and attitude is what we need to remember of what? Of the landforms, of the rocks. So that is important in structure part. Then process part is what? All those processes that we have studied in denudation chronology, right from process 1 to 4. So that is what? The weathering, erosion, mass wasting, all these things that we study as transportation, deposition. So all these features of denudational chronology are important as
processes which are external to this particular structure, right? So if there is a structure and then there is externality, so this is what the process is all about. And then obviously, because it talks about stages of evolution, so time is important, and that is what it has been divided here in this cycle of erosion as youth, mature and old. So why it has been given as youth, mature and old? So it basically means, like human beings, the analogy has been drawn from human beings. And remember, this theory came in 1889. So remember in 1859 what happened? In 1859, Darwin came out with the theory of evolution of species, origin of species. So there was a great influence of the thinkers of that time in every field. So what happened? In the field of physical geography as well, Darwin influenced scholars like Davis. And remember, that is why this human evolution was now analyzed, and further, the analogy was drawn onto the physical landscape. That's where you see this imprint, youth, mature and old. Like we grow as human beings into youth, mature and old. Similarly, landscape as well, they evolve. They from youth to mature to old, there is a cycle. They have a life cycle. So that is what we study in this structure, process and stage, or what we say as time. So this is also referred to as trio of Davis at many places. You'll see structure, process and time, or structure, process or stage. So this is what we say as trio of Davis. So this is important, and this is which paves way for a particular landscape. That is important here in this particular theory of landscape or landforms development. Now, before we go ahead, let's understand the basic premise or the basic principles of this theory. So what are the basic principles on which this theory is based? The first principle, that landforms like organic forms. Now remember, we have just talked about that it was drawn as human analogy. So landforms also like organic forms shall be studied in view of their evolution. Remember, so the impact of Darwinism on the theory of evolution of landforms as well. Then landforms' initial uplift is the chief source of energy. So basically, the chief source of energy for this evolution, the beginning, is coming from this initial uplift. So remember, this was a flat land and then it started uplifting, as we know. That is a tectonic process and other processes involved in this. So this started uplifting. So initial uplift that we say is the important part of this chief source of energy. That was the second principle. Then, throughout the landform assemblage, leading ultimately to a specialty uniform terrain, which Davis called as peneplain. So basically, the first stage was before this initial uplift, that is the beginning, the origin point. It was a plain surface, then it uplifted, then it went into this particular cycle, and then at the end of the cycle, again it came back to the same plane where it started. So that is why it is cyclic in nature, starts from plane and ends to plane. So that is what we say as the peneplain. So that is important, that end product, what we say in Davis cycle of erosion, that is called peneplain. It's again a plane which is made after the evolution of landforms. Then, while the landmass is being uplifted, now at this particular juncture, when it is uplifted, there is very little or no erosion. So this is important principle to remember in Davis theory, that is remarkably very important in his theory specifically, where it has been also criticized later on, that he said that while this uplifting process is going on, there is no external forces acting. So it means he said that no erosion happens here. So it means it was an assumption, it was a basic principle that while it is uplifting, all the external processes are banned. So that is important to remember. Then, uniform lithology. So in his basic principle, the next one is that the entire area which is now uplifted has same rock structure, same rock types. It means their hardness, their porosity, their permeability, the components that we study, right? Folding, faulting, all these systems. So lithology is one important thing where rock structure and composition is involved. So that is to be uniform. So this theory is applied in the areas where there has been uniformity in the evolution of the rock structure. Then Davis divided these stages into youth, mature and old. So this is the sixth principle. So now I hope that these principles will enable you to automatically understand the theory later on when we are discussing in a better way. So remember these principles, and these hold key for the theory. So now let's elaborate. So Davis defined a geographical cycle as sequence. Again, I say the word was sequential change in landscape. So sequence of changes which an uplifted block has to undergo before it gets reduced to the base level or peneplain. So now see, this is the initial position in this graph where it is not uplifted, and then the uplifting starts, right? And the cycle does not start unless it is completely uplifted to this point. So this particular place before upliftment is not having the externality. Remember, no erosion, nothing, no process acting, only upliftment phase is there. So this is important. And then what happens when this uplifted block undergoes the changes through time? So this is what is there. So height and time graph is there. So what happens now here, you see in the graph, youth stage, then maturity, then old stage. And what we see gradually, this height is again put back to the base level. Now this concept of base level, which was given earlier, so remember in 1875, almost 14 years before Davis actually included this concept of base level in his own theory, it was given by Powell, who was another geologist. So base level was defined by Powell in 1875, which is said to be that particular level beyond which erosion doesn't occur. So it is almost like a flat plain. So beyond this, there is no further erosion happening. So no further going down before being below this particular level. So this is that level below which a channel cannot erode. So remember, this is what he defined as base level, which was used by Davis in his theory. And he says that once the upliftment stops, then the journey from this highest point to this lowest point of base level starts. And in that journey, there are three stages. First is the youth, then is the mature, and the third is the old stages. So now, one by one, let's discuss what happens in each of these stages. That is, what is the feature of youth stage, what is the feature of maturity, and what happens in the old age, and how finally this particular peneplain, that is why we say this theory, peneplanation. So how this is formed. So let's discuss these stages. So the first stage, what we see is the youthful stage. So what are its various features? Let's understand. So erosion starts after the completion of the upliftment of landmass. So basically, when it is now finally uplifted to this point, now what happens? Erosion starts happening. So what happens? There is a declination in slope starting now. That is why it is also known as slope decline theory. So remember, the top surfaces or the summits of the water divides. Remember, this is the top surface here, the summits of the water divide. So they are not affected by erosion because the river are small. So now Davis says that in youth stage, the highest points are not affected. Why? Because the streams that form on these slopes, because of the rainfall factor that we see, the initial slope that develops is not big enough to actually erode this particular summit. So just beneath that summit, the secondary section of this particular slope, the erosion is now starting to take place. So what happens? Small rivers, short tributaries, that is what we know by the name of consequent streams. So what are these consequent streams? The word is consequence. So what is the consequence all about? It is basically talking about the first impact of the rainfall, and then finally when the consequent streams develop because of this particular formation of channels, these streams, the smaller tributaries. So what happens? They start doing headward erosion, due to which they extend their length. So this is the first important point here. Then, because of steep slope, now here is a steepness here, right? So steep slope and steep channel gradient, that is the degree of slope, the channel that develops on the slope has steep channel gradient. River actively deepens their valleys through vertical erosion. So remember, in youthful stages, the maximum erosion is vertical in nature. So down cutting is there rather than just sideways cutting of the valley. So suppose if this is a valley, so it means in the initial stage, it will be very down cutting, not side cutting. So side cutting is very minimal. It is mostly what is the deepening happens. So the valley becomes very deep and narrow, characterized by steep valley sides, that is slopes of convex plan. So it is very steep valleys that we see in the youthful stage of this particular cycle of erosion. Now, what is there in the mature stage then? Then further, with maturity, that is in mature stage, it is marked by lateral erosion. Remember, we talked about vertical erosion. When it gets mature, then this erosion not just happens downwards, but also laterally, that is sideways. So what happens now? The valley starts broadening up. So earlier, it was not this broad. Now, because of this side cutting that we say, lateral erosion, it has now been integrated to the main drainage network. So what happens? Vertical erosion slows down and horizontal actions increases. Now this down cutting slows down and side cutting is taking over here. So what happens? The summits of water divides are also eroded. Now, which was not eroded initially, now this also starts getting lower down. This also starts getting eroded now in this particular age. And there is marked lowering of absolute relief. So this absolute relief, that is the highest divide that we say, now this is now coming here. Gradually now they are going down. So lateral erosion leads to valley widening. So remember this phrase valley widening, which is the prominent feature of mature stage, and valley deepening was prominent feature of the earlier, that is the youth stage. So what happens? The marked reduction in valley deepening here. So valley deepening reduces, valley widening increases. So vertical erosion is less, and that is what we say as valley incision. This is now less, while the lateral part is now more, as we discussed. So this is because of this particular substantial decrease in channel gradients, flow velocity, transportation capacity. So remember, these things we have already discussed in the denudational processes. So what happens now? The channel gradients are now not that steep. Gradually they are now going parallel to this base level. So what happens now? There is a broadening of the valley rather than deepening. Flow velocity reduces because now the slope is now getting gentler. Transportation capacity is all about the energy of the river or the stream to carry the material. That also decreases. So that is important now. So how soon youth will turn into maturity? Now this is a question. This depends upon what? To a large extent on the texture of the drainage. Now remember, if the drainage is smooth, or is it zigzag, or is it flowing through a hard rock area? So what is the rock structure all about? Can it easily cut through that? So these are the things on which the maturity of this particular river depends. So nature of the river is all about the flow, the gradient, the material that it carries, but nature of the slope is equally important. So it depends upon the balance of what we talk about here, that how easily will it get to mature stage, will it take more time. So that all depends upon this particular texture of drainage and also the texture of land surface. Now at the last, what we see is the old stage. So what happens here? Again, the same process, the gentle gradient accentuated by horizontal action and deposition reduces further the erosion intensity. So valley widening was there. Now further it is more going to the planar surface. So more widening happens. Slope angle reduces. So if this was the earlier slope angle, now it has reduced to this angle. So that is the difference now here. Old stage is characterized by almost total absence of valley incision. So which was highest in youth stage, which became slow in the mature stage, is now almost completely absent in the older stage. Now, lateral erosion and valley widening is still active process. So this lateral erosion and widening of the valley is still happening here. So water divides are more rapidly eroded. So remember, now these summits are now further eroded gradually. Now it is coming to the base level as we are going to the old stage. So there is rapid rate of decrease of absolute height. Relative or available relief also decreases sharply because of the active lateral erosion, but no vertical erosion. So this is what is the significant difference here. So if we want to look through the images, what is we can see here is that what happens in the youth stage, what happens in the mature stage, and what happens in the old stage. Just look at these images here on your screen. So what happens? Initial surfaces here. Now you see the valley deepening is more, not the widening. In this, valley widening starts in mature stage, right? And in old stage, the absolute height which was at this particular location is now finally reduced to almost the base level, and valley widening is happening, almost deepening is absent. So this is what we see in these images. So same in this particular 3D image if you see, and in this particular mountains to plains to the further delta areas. So this is what happens. So now let's analyze this table, where cycle is there, youth stage is there, maturity is there, and old is there. So it should be in sequence where youth, mature and old should be there, but in this table, it's just reversed a little. So be careful. Now here, cycle of drainage development, what we see is that major rivers are there in youth, then maturity, floodplains are there, and in old, rivers with floods are there, which are very flat. Then in cycle of slope development, what happens? Convex slope is there, convex is this, and concave is this. So remember, convex slope is there, vertical downcut is there. Then in this particular maturity, flattening happens of this particular convex, right? And then in old, there is lateral erosion, and almost it's like parallel to the base level. Then in cycle of landscape development, if you see what happens, V-shaped valley is there. So what is this V-shaped valley? Then what we see is low surface, low gradient, that what happens in maturity, and finally lateral development is completely almost like a flat surface. So this is what we discussed in the three stages, youth, mature and old. Many times it is called young, mature and old as well. Now it's important to remember that there are lots of interruptions in the cycle as well. Now remember, this entire phenomena does not happen without any external factor influencing it. It means there are lots of externalities, and also internal forces are there many times, like tectonic forces, uplifting, warping, all these things that we have learned already in geomorphology. So what happens? There are lots of interruptions in this cycle. This cycle does not go as it is described, as very smooth. First uplift will happen, and then, you know, further there will be a slope decline. So what happens? Based on the concept of geomorphology, complexity of geomorphic evolution. Now remember this statement, it can be asked as a question for mains exam as well, that elaborate this statement. So complexity of geomorphic evolution is more common than simplicity. So what is more common? Simplicity is not common. Complexity is more common in geomorphology. So that's why this cycle of erosion is also not that simple as we understand from the description, but rather if you go and observe on the ground, it has lots of complexity. So one of the complexity is because of this phenomena that happens, which is called rejuvenation. So now rejuvenation, literally if you take, what is that? It is bringing back the youth stage again. So if a person is now dressed up well, going to a party, what do we say? You're looking very young today. So it means basically he has been or she has been rejuvenated. So rejuvenation is all about gaining back your youth. So how does it happen here? So dynamic rejuvenation is one important thing that we need to understand, that is caused by epirogenetic uplift. Remember, epiros, that is continental building here. So what happens? Continental formations we have already studied. So because of this uplifting factor, many times what happens, as we understand from this feature, that gradually this absolute height is decreasing, suddenly we find that no, again it is increasing. Why this anomaly? So why this interruption? So it means this youth stage now, which was going to old, suddenly becomes youth again. So that is important, and it is accompanied by tilting, warping, all these phenomena that we have already studied. Now, localized downcutting, this is another important factor. So warping or faulting of a drainage, which now have transporting power. So suddenly the stream level was this particular level, right? And suddenly if this block on which it is going to further, it goes down. So what happens? It goes vertically downward. So gradient increases of the channel. So suddenly lateral cutting reduces and down cutting starts happening again. So this is one factor that can also happen. Then lowering or rise of sea level. Now if this is the flatter surface, what happens if there is a rise of sea level? So this water which was now getting here, now it is going back here. So what happens? The valley is finally happening to be again going back from the particular old stage to mature stage to youth stage. So there is a reversal kind of thing happening here at the mouth of the stream itself. So now again the entire process will start happening from that point. So this kind of rejuvenations keep happening in nature, forming the complexity of geomorphic landforms evolution. So this is where it is important to understand that Dewis concept is not that absolute way of looking at the landscape when we actually go to the field. So it may look a little complex, but for understanding this concept, this theory holds a key value.
So when we have learned about the concept of cycle of erosion by William Morris Dewis, now in the lectures to come, we are going to talk about Penck's concept as well as L.C. King's concept. So stay safe, stay tuned, and all the best.